Author, if you want to be an author, I'm going to tell you a couple of things. One, Stephen Campbell is watching right now. I see him viewing this. Not him personally, but I see his name up there. Go through there and click on Stephen Campbell. Find him. He does a wonderful, thorough podcast for writers and authors. And they are self-published, in most cases, self-published authors that promote themselves. Gives great advice, great things. I'm going to put a link to Stephen's podcast in the edited version. So come back here in the next day or two, or go on the YouTube channel. That'll be on there in the next day or two, and I'll put a link to Stephen's podcast in there. But here's what I tell you: for if you're aspiring to be a writer or an author, a writer to an author, find out what is your best time of day. When are you the most creative? When are you the most driven or the most focused that you can just sit down and be focused on one thing? Mine is in the morning. I like to get up early in the morning. I like to meditate. I like to get that's my best time of day. So that would be the prime time for me to write. Once the day starts rolling out, clouded. My brain gets clouded. I get too many things coming at me. And then it's not going to be a great time to focus or get into that. Could I do it? Maybe, but it's not going to be the best work that I can do. So find out what works for you. Or are you a nighttime person that it's all of a sudden like 8, 9 o'clock at night and you're like, ooh, this is when the juices start flowing. Figure that out, because that's what you're going to want to do. You want to set aside times in those areas. If it's morning, get up 15 minutes earlier. If you haven't written before, but you're like, there's a story burning inside of me, just say, you know what? I'm going to get up 15 minutes earlier, and I'm going to, after I have my morning coffee or whatever it is, I'm going to take some time, and I'm going to just write for 15 minutes. So that's what you want to do. Or at night, it's like, you know what? I'm going to go slide off into a side room for a while, and I'm just going to write for a while. And if it, you know, all of a sudden it's going to go from 15, you're going to realize it's a half hour, and then it's an hour and things like that. But start out small. Don't get overwhelmed. Don't overwhelm yourself by going, oh my gosh, I have to write a novel. How am I going to get this done in 30 days? That's overwhelming. Don't do it. Secondly, start out. I put down there short by short. Just if you've never written before, don't, like I said, don't plan on writing a novel. Okay, start out with the short story. Maybe it's just a one page. And then you go, I could tweak this, I could do that, I could do, you know, and then you get the juices flowing and just start out with very short, you know, like as I said in the beginning segment, you can put 10 short stories together and now you have a book. You know, that you could publish as short stories. Just think way back when Laura Ingalls Wilder, she didn't sit there and go, I'm going to write a series of books. She just started writing and they became a series of books, right? So there you go. Now, software. Now, I don't know if Stephen will tell you something different, but I'm going to tell you Scrivener. It's $40. What OBS is to Facebook and going live and doing a show like this and giving you some free production. Scrivener is going to give you a lot of tools for writing that you can now organize those things. So you can move things around within there. It's $40, I believe, for the software. And if they raised the price or did differently. But now in both cases, it's users that are going to improve it. So it's not going to be the creme de la creme. It's not going to like hook up to your website and all of a sudden pop out a novel or something like that. It's basically made for writers. So Scrivener is made for writers, but you can move things around. So if you know, you just put a chapter in there and you're like, I'll figure out where that chapter goes later on, and you start changing things as you go, if you're writing a novel or a short story or something, you can move those within it. So it's easy to, you know, it's just kind of pulling, you know, you can now make chapter one now is chapter three or vice versa or something like that. So it makes it easy to edit. It makes it easy to put in there. You can use Word as your format to, you know, type the story in, and then you can, you know, put Word into Scrivener and that. And so it's a nice, easy, inexpensive way to test your writing skills. Do you have the chops to do it? And you may find out, I'm not a big believer in overspending on software and overspending on things just to find out that you didn't like it. You don't go out and buy a $3,000 Trek bike and then realize, I really don't like to bike. You know, you go and you buy a bike and you go and you try it out for a while, or you rent a bike, or you know, in this case, it's almost like renting a program. $40 for software nowadays that can do as much as Scrivener can is pretty amazing. You can't get much for $40 for software out there, and it's not a membership. It's not anything like that. You can donate to help, you know, perpetuate it more, but for the most part, you're going to pay $40 for the software and that's it. For most people. But give it a test run. See if you're a writer or not. Then you can organize yourself. But start out small and let it grow. You know, if it catches on fire and you just start writing and you start getting more, you know, whether it's novels, short stories, gothic, romances. I mean, there's so many different books that are self-help, you know, books that are out there. You know, you can do that very easily, but start small. Start out with one story and just let it go. But, you know, start out, don't overwhelm yourself, because that's where a lot of times people that have beautiful stories inside them block it, you know. Oh, someday I'm going to write that book. Someday I'm going to do that. Someday I'm going to go on Facebook. Someday I'm going to help people out. Today is your someday. This is your wake-up call. Slap you in the face. Wake up and start doing it tomorrow. Start doing it today. If you're a nighttime person, 6:30 at night here, or 7 o'clock at night central time here. So if you're a nighttime person, this could be the time to start writing. Or this could be the time to start, you know, putting together your Facebook show or your YouTube show. If you need other help, Steven's a great one for writing. I can just give you some of this basic information, but Steven's going to be a great one for that. And if you need help with a Facebook show, I can certainly help you get going and get in the right direction. We're here to help you. There's people out there that are dying to help you in any form or fashion to get things going, because that's the way we're going to turn things around here in America, right? We're going to help each other out. We're going to flourish and be strong again. But eliminate your distractions. Overall, eliminate your distractions. Go to where your creative energy is. Sometimes you'll see a lot of writers, a lot of authors, a lot of bloggers. If you want to blog, that's the same thing. You're writing, right? If you want to blog, you'll see a lot of those at coffee shops. Go there. They got their creative juices flowing. I'll guarantee you, you'll get those creative juices flowing too. You'll take your laptop, sit there, and just start clicking away. That was a lot for a half hour. Thanks for joining. I appreciate you coming along on the journey. If you have questions, shoot them to me on email, dave@davestelma.com. We'll get you there. Otherwise, like my Facebook page, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and go out there and make it a great week. If you like this video, like my Facebook page or subscribe to my YouTube channel, or find everything at davestelma.com.